And now I'm joined by Trey Smith, the creative director on NBA Jam. Sir, how you doing?
Oh, great, great.
Awesome. So, you know, took a look at NBA Jam back at E3 and kind of the pre-E3 event. It seems like you've got the classics, the classic NBA Jam stuff down. It feels like those old Midway games with a, you know, kind of an updated feel. But that's not what you're just showing just now. You're talking about boss battles, lots of the crazy stuff. What else is in the game?
Sure. That classic experience was key for us. It's our bread and butter. We know that's where people are showing up. But that being said, it's been 17 years, and we got to bring some more to the party. So that's when this idea of Remix Tour came along. And it's really kind of just, it's a dynasty mode if the kind of Nintendo was part of it. It's like twists, turns, surprises. You don't know what's going on. It's 30 different locations, so each team has a location. And in each one of those locations, you got a bronze, a silver, and a gold challenge. And those slots are taken up by 7 different game modes, one of which is Backboard Smash, which we're showing. And some of the other ones are like boss battles. And it's just kind of a harkens to the old school one-on-one boss battles of lore. I mean, it's just really, really fun to kind of sit into that Punch-Out type thing where you go in and you just get your ass handed to you right away.
Yeah, so I saw that you had Yao Ming before, you know, just like giant Yao Ming, and now Magic Johnson teleporting all over the court. Can we expect more NBA legends, any like non-basketball players that show up as weird bosses or anything like that?
It's a nice mix of legends and some of the current superstars, and it's really just about playing up their real personas. It's like, what are they known for? And then we make them kind of superhuman in that sense and kind of play that up. But it's so key to have that aha moment, you know, where you play, you get beat, you get beat, you get beat, and then all of a sudden, oh, that Achilles heel, that chink in the armor, I just figured it out, and then you have to execute on it. So yeah, it's just old school boss battle goodness. That's what we were going for.
Are they playing money matches around there? Is there money changing hands? That seemed like that was always the Turmel way, is when I went to play him at Blitz, I actually had to put money on the table before we could do it.
Yeah, it's up in Vancouver. There have been some loonies and some toonies passed back and forth. Yes, we could say that.
That's all we can say for legal reasons. Do not gamble and play NBA Jam.
That's
it's totally possible.
You can do it.
You got a lot of hidden stuff in there, obviously, that you're probably still not ready to talk about, but you know, we can expect big head mode. Like, is your head in the game? Your head has to be in the game.
You know, there's lots of good stuff. Yeah, that secret stuff is so key to it. For me personally, you guys out there, you don't want to play with me. You know,
if you're better than the NBA players, then
I know. I'm big on that. It's just any time that we put forth putting me in the game is something that we could do, putting somebody really special that people really want to play. So I'm not in the game, but that's by design. But there are some other familiar characters that have made their way into it, and we pay homage to the original Jam and a lot of things that go on. We made this game for hardcore Jam fans, and that's what we went for. So it's stuff that those guys wanted to play.
What are you guys working on right now? Is it just kind of like everything's in and you're just kind of making sure that it's all tight before you ship?
Yeah, right now it's tuning, polishing, balancing. Difficulty is a big one. In the classic campaign, it's a ladder tournament, so it's worst to first, and there's no linear path whatsoever. I mean, you just go straight through. So we need to make sure there's no choke points where all of a sudden the difficulty spikes in the 7th match, and then all of a sudden. So that's being focus tested right now. And a lot of the Remix games, the AI and that as well, there's so many different strategies. Backboard Smash, where you have to smash the other opponent's backboard, you still need to make it where if you don't have a strong dunker on a team, those guys still need to be able to win. So it's a lot of just tweaking numbers and databases under the hood and that kind of thing. It's identifying some rough animations here and there, smoothing them out. Yeah, I mean, we're very, very far along. We're wrapping some things up. We're still hoping to pull in online. We're not there yet. I got a couple of guys hammering on that. But everything else is coming together so well and so great. We got up to 60 frames per second. That was a huge one for us.
That's key.
And the pleasant surprise to that was our rendering team was so strong, and the visual quality didn't really drop. I mean, you put it side by side, and 60 just looks and plays, and it's so much better. So, yeah, it's we're wrapping it up, and people are loving it. And thanks to you guys, really, for helping us spread the word. It's so great. The team is so psyched.
There was a show last weekend called California Extreme. It's a big old arcade convention. A bunch of collectors come together and have cabinets and stuff. We made it out of there with an NBA Jam cabinet.
Wow.
$200.
Oh, that's awesome. Well,
that has been the reaction people have had as soon as I say $200.
Well,
it'll be cool because we'll be able to just straight up have the arcade machine right there for comparison's sake. Are you ready for that? Are you ready for that moment?
Yes, absolutely. And I'm so jealous. I've been searching eBay for 2 years now, trying to find them, and the shipping alone for those
the shipping
things.
Is crazy. When are you looking to hit shelves?
We're hitting shelves October 5th.
Cool. Trey, thank you very much for your time.
Cheers.